Hi traders, Lance Beggs here from yourtradingcoach.com. Today we're going to continue our introduction to candlestick analysis, looking at the concept of candlestick development and candlestick addition. You may hear this referred to by other names such as candle subtraction and addition. I use development and addition because that is what I was first taught. To be honest though, whatever name you choose is not important. What is important is that you understand this very important concept in candlestick analysis. What is it? Let's take a look. This candle here, you obviously recognise as bullish based on the work we did in previous videos. The bulls have driven the price from the open near the low of the candle here and closed it up near the high of the candle here. Clearly bullish, right? However, consider for a second a single candle on a daily chart. If you drop down to, say, an hourly chart, that same daily time frame might now be made up of 6 hourly candles if you're analysing stocks. If it's Forex, it might be made up of 24 hourly candles. In any case, that same price movement that is represented by one candle can also be represented by a greater number of candles from a smaller time frame chart. Here in this example, let's say this bullish candle is from a daily chart of your favourite stock. You would be able to drop down to the hourly chart and see the inner workings of this candle. For example, here we have 6 hourly candles representing that same move from the daily open, down here, to the daily close, here. This process of breaking a candle down into its component parts is called candle development. Candle development gives you greater insight into the sentiment within the candle. For example, let's compare 3 different scenarios that could lead to this same large bullish candle you see on the left. In this example, the first one that we've already looked at, the bullish candle was produced by a single bullish push from the open up to the highs, which then stalled at some fairly solid upper resistance. Whereas in this example, the same candle develops from a different combination of hourly candles. In this case, the initial bullish move experiences some bearish retaliation, as the bears push it back to around the 0.618 retracement, for those Fibonacci fans, before the bulls take back control and push the price up into the close. A slightly different scenario to the first with regards to the sentiment of the single candle. And here's another. In this case, the same bullish candle develops simply from price meandering casually for the full range from low to high or open to close, without any rapid bullish thrust or bearish rejection of prices. Once again, a slightly different picture to the previous examples. Let's look at another example. This candle here, is it bullish or bearish? Well, it's a little difficult to tell. The body is showing a slight victory of the bulls over the bears, based on the green colouring. But it's a very small range body, and there's significant rejection of higher prices, showing strength in the bears, and significant rejection of lower prices, showing strength in the bulls. Really, no side can claim a victory based on this candle alone. Could candle development perhaps provide some insight? Breaking this candle down into component parts may show, for example, an initial bullish move that is rapidly rejected, but then falls into an area of clear support. The bears then are exhausted and overcome by the bulls, who are able to push the price back to the vicinity of the open. While still not a clear victory either way, the process of candle development has given us clues as to potential areas of intraday support and resistance, and is showing the bulls clearly able to get the final upper hand leading into the close of the candle. Contrast that with the same candle developing from a slightly different set of shorter time frame candles. In this case, the exact opposite. An initial bearish move rapidly rejected by the bulls, who drive the price all the way up to a clear area of resistance. The bulls meet significant opposition here, enough to exhaust all the bulls and then drive the price back to close just above the open. Once again, we've got great insight into potential intraday support and resistance, and can see the bears in this case getting the final upper hand. And if you clearly understand the process of candle development now, being the process of breaking a single candle down into its component parts, you'll be happy to know that candle addition is quite simple, being the exact opposite process. In this case, we take a group of candles and combine or add them to produce one single candle. Looking at the example we saw before, these candles here, through the process of candle addition, moving from the open of the first candle to the close of the last candle, become the candle on the right. And this group of candles, through the process of candle addition, moving from the open of the first candle to the high, to the low, and to the close of the last candle, becomes this same candle on the right, from the open to the high, to the low, and to the close. And this sequence of candles, is it bullish or bearish? Well, we learned how to analyse a single candle in the last video, so let's use the process of candlestick addition to produce an equivalent single candle, moving from the open to the low and to the close of the last candle. This movement or the process of candle addition produces the candle you now see on the right. Price moving from the open of the first candle to the low and up to the close on the last candle. From the open to the low and to the close. Now we can easily analyse this single candle on the right. A bearish body, but with rejection of lower prices indicating bullish. Okay, in this case, we don't get a clear indication of one side being in control. Sometimes you will get a clear indication of bullish sentiment or bearish sentiment. Other times you won't. That's right, it's not the holy grail and doesn't always provide us with a definitive answer regarding who's in control. But that's fine, because there's more we need to discuss yet in future videos. The fact is that, depending on where this pattern occurred within the context of the trend, it could be a bullish pattern known as a hammer, it could be a bearish pattern known as a hanging man, and it could be nothing at all, but we'll cover that in future videos. For now, we need a quick summary and an opportunity for you to do some further practice before we continue with the lessons. So why do we care about candle development and candle addition? Candle development allows us to see the inner workings of a candle. It allows us to see the battle between the bulls and bears, the constant changing of sentiment back and forward, and how that resolves over time to develop the final single candle pattern. It allows us greater insight into the sentiment within a candle. Candle addition, though, allows us to represent a group of candles as one single candle, in order to more easily determine the bullish or bearish sentiment of that group. You recall in the last video we discussed how to determine the bullish or bearish sentiment of a single candle. Well, now with candle addition, you have the power to determine the sentiment of any sequence of candles. How cool is that? So go look at some charts. Have a look at how the hourly time frame candles combine together to produce the daily candles through the process of candle addition. Or have a look at how the weekly candles break down into the daily candles through the process of candle development. In the next video, we'll wrap up the introduction to candlestick analysis, discussing the stages of a candlestick pattern. I realise you probably want to start seeing the reversal patterns. Hang in there, just one more introduction video to go. I'm Lance Beggs from www.yourtradingcoach.com. Wishing you happy trading.